At Wolf, we saw an opportunity to ruggedize the Xavier in a 3U VPX form factor, so it would be able to withstand the rigors of military and aerospace deployment in the air, over land, at sea, and in space. But we also wanted to add more digital and analog I/O that was suited to these applications. First, we started with the environmental design, ensuring it would meet the specifications for temperature, shock, vibration, and power. But we also wanted to meet OpenCOT standards as they were defined for ANSI VITA 48 for mechanical power and data rates, and 65 for open VPX profiles. The Xavier was well received from the industry with great reviews, mostly for its AI performance and its performance per watt, which is critical to meet the size, weight, and power constraints of military and aerospace deployment. The initial customer demand we're seeing is for GPGPU operations, graphics output, inference, video processing, radar and signal processing, and autonomous applications, one of the areas we're keeping a really close eye on. At the heart of the Xavier are 8 Carmel ARM cores, CUDA cores, and Tensor cores, along with deep learning accelerators and vision accelerators. All this computing power is coupled with 16 gigabytes of memory, 3 DisplayPort outputs, and it has respectable encoding and decoding capability for both H.264 and H.265. For storage, you can use the 32 gigabytes of MMC on the Xavier itself, but by using Wolf's design, you have the added option of a 256 gigabyte or 1 terabyte SSD. Or we can even enable off-module SATA. Our 3U VPX rugged design features an added PCIe switch with an optional non-transparent bridge, so it can be configured as a root complex or an endpoint, while also supporting device lending, multicasting, and asymmetric multiprocessing using software from Dolphin Interconnect. Our first release of the rugged Xavier product is going to be supporting the 1 gigabit Ethernet that's available from the Xavier SoC itself, but we will be adding a dual 1 gig E, 10 gig E interface that's compatible with SOSA, so you could interface to this module entirely through the LAN interface if you wanted to. For the conduction-cooled version, the default rear I/O configuration will be as follows with USB 3.1, control ports like RS-232, GPIO, SpyBus, and some other hooks you'll see in our interface control document, but we'll also have SDI and composite signals available, and those are considered converted outputs that are produced with the real-time conversion through the Wolf FGX. It's important to note, by using the Wolf FGX, we can also enable support for ARINC 818, CoaXPress, and other video interfaces. For the air-cooled version, we can offer similar interfaces on the front I/O panel, and we can mix and match those signals between the front and rear I/O, depending on the configuration. The Xavier product is available as a commercial off-the-shelf product, or we can modify it to suit your needs. To find out more information about our Xavier products, you can call one of our sales engineers at 905-852-1163 and press 1 for sales. Or you can visit our website at wolf.ca to see our entire selection of 3U VPX, 6U VPX, XMC, MXC, MXM, and small form factor products.